Hey, what's up guys, Zonis again from my Geeks blog. Multitasking and productivity go hand in hand, and do you feel that your workflow on your iPad needs to be more fluid? If yes, keep watching this video because I'm going to show you over 20 iPad multitasking tips to help you double down on productivity. First, let's take a look at the gestures to quickly switch between the apps. The dock is designed to let you switch between apps with ease. Simply swipe up from the bottom edge of the screen from any app to access the dock. Then select the app you wish to use. It's that straightforward. You can also switch between recently opened apps by swiping right or left on the home bar. Or you can swipe left or right using 5 or 4 fingers. It's super handy, isn't it? Just make sure that gestures is enabled on your iPad by going to Settings, General, Multitasking and Dock, and ensure that switch for gestures is on. You can also invoke the app switcher by swiping all the way up from the bottom edge of the screen like this and then hold in the middle of the screen to get you to the app switcher. It is quite straightforward to take a glance at all the opened apps and jump into the one you want to use. If you are using physical keyboard, Command plus Tab keys come super handy to switch between recently opened apps. Generally, we click the home button or swipe up from the home bar to go to the home screen, right? But you can make it more quick by using the 4 or 5 finger pinch to access the home screen on your iPad. It feels more intuitive and fluid. I think most of you would be knowing how to kill apps on iPad. Just bring up app switcher and then swipe up the app you wish to force quit. But there is an effective way you can shoot out multiple apps at one go. To get it done, place your two fingers on the app cards and then swipe up. Well, if you want to force quit apps even faster, use the fingers of both of your hands to kill up to 4 apps at one go. Split view can be a boon for your productivity, as you can use these multitasking features to work with 2 apps simultaneously. So you can create a shopping list while snapping a look at the hottest fashion trends in another app. From the dock, I assume that the first app is already opened. Then bring the dock and drag the second app and then drop it at the left or right edge of the screen. You can also invoke split view from home screen. It is a bit tricky. What you have to do is select the app of your choice from the home screen and drag it in towards the bottom. While still dragging the app, use your other finger to open the first app from the dock and then drop it. To invoke split view from the app switcher, drag an app from the dock. Next, drop it on the app you want to use at a time. If you want to use an app that is on the home screen, drag it towards the bottom and then use your other finger to swipe up till the middle of the screen to access the app switcher. Then after, drop the app on the one you want to use together. The same rule will apply for slide over. So use this trick to use any of the 2 multitasking features. Based on your need, you can resize the split view windows to use 2 apps comfortably. For instance, you can put them in multiple proportions like 50x50, 75x25 or 25x75. To do so, use the tiny handle and drag it towards left or right to increase or decrease the size of the specific window. Swapping the position of the split view app is quite easy. To do so, use the drag handle at the top of the window and drag it on the other side. It's pretty simple to replace the apps in the split view. Just bring the dock, drag an app and drop it at the left or right edge of the screen. All your grouped apps in split view stay together unless you have removed them. If you ever want to view or use them, all you have to do is bring the apps feature and here you can see the grouped apps. Just tap on it if you want to use them. Just like split view, slide over also lets you use two apps simultaneously. However, the latter is slightly different from the former. Suppose the first app is already open on your iPad, then drag the second one and drop it in the middle of the screen. The second app will display at the top of the first one, and it will take just one quarter of the screen. At any time you want to swap the slide over app, simply drag an app from the dock and drop it in the middle of the screen. You can reposition the slide over app with this. Just touch the drag handle and place it on any side of the screen. Besides, you can also hide it simply dragging the slide over app towards the right edge of the screen. And to reveal it, swipe left from the right edge of the screen. One thing that worth remembering is that you can't hide the slide over app in the left side of the screen. You are working on two apps in split view. Suddenly you think it would be better to switch to slide over. All you have to do is swipe down from the top drag handle. Likewise, you can quickly switch to split view from slide over. It works perfectly, allowing you to switch between the two modes seamlessly. Many a time we want to catch up with fun-loving videos while browsing the web or making a project, and that's when PIP mode comes into play. There are two quick ways you can activate PIP mode. While one way is to use 5-finger pinch when a video is playing in full screen, the other is to use the PIP button. Now let's take a look at how to use split view plus side over plus PIP mode all together. You guessed it, didn't you? By clubbing split view, slide over and PIP mode, you can use as many as 4 apps at a time. Save it for the times when you want to kill multiple birds with one stone. First of all, open a supported app and then hit the PIP button or pinch with 5 fingers to enter picture-in-picture mode. Next, launch any app and then drop another one on the left or right edge of the screen to invoke split view. Then you need to drag a new app and make sure to drop it on the app divider to initiate slide over. Now check out, there are 4 apps on the same screen. Now go ahead and use them to carry out your task faster while also enjoying the video. You can put 2 different apps side by side to work on both of them at a time. But if you wish to place 2 web pages on the same screen so that you can scan through them a bit more conveniently, there is a quick way to get it done. Supposing a web page is open in Safari and your iPad is in landscape mode, touch and hold the tab icon at the top right corner of the screen and then choose open split view. Now the screen will be divided into 2 parts and you will get the option to search a website on the other tab. Later, if you want to quit the split view mode and merge all the tabs, touch and hold the tab button at the top right and choose merge all tabs. Spotlight can come in handy in many ways. Case in point, you can use these nifty features to quickly access any app and use it in a split view or slide over. Swipe down from the middle of the screen to bring up Spotlight. If you are using a physical keyboard, press Command plus space. Now you will see your most recently used apps. You can also search an app to access it instantly. Once the app shows up, touch and hold it, drag it towards the bottom, select an already open app and drop it. Drag and drop is yet another impressive feature that can hugely enhance your user experience. It allows you to drag content from one app and drop it in another. Suppose you want to drop several images or clips in the Notes app, just open the Photos app, touch and hold a pic, drag it to an empty place on the screen of the Notes app. Use your other finger to select other images, swipe up from the bottom to bring up Dock and then drop it in the desired app. Likewise, you can select text, URL, attachments and drop it at the preferred destination. That's all guys. Now that all the smart hacks are at your disposal, give them a shot to speed up your work and also save plenty of time. Beyond that, it can also add some fun element into the way you go about the job on your iPad. If I missed any multitasking tip, please share wildcard entries in the comments down below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If yes, please hit the thumbs up button, share this video and subscribe to this channel for such interesting videos. I am Dhvanesh signing off and we'll catch you in the next one.